Happy afternoon, children. How are you all? I welcome you to the next session of English. This is the session for grade 9. Hope so you are all staying safe at home and learning process is also going on. Have the habit of doing everyday's work, children. And how was the moderator session on Saturday? Are you all satisfied with the session? Let us move into today's session. What is the lesson we are seeing now? The sound of music. Look at the slide which is given for you. What are these symbols? And what does this sign represents then? These symbols give us an idea of the music. This is something related to the lesson. Do you read the lesson, children? Have you completed reading part 1? Have you completed reading part 1? I asked you to read part 1. Did you enjoy the lesson? It is something interesting. It is an inspirational story of a great musician. As I have told you, it is an inspirational story of a great musician. What is the title of the lesson again? The Sound of Music. And this is the idea I have given you in the last class itself. Part 1 deals with Evelyn Glennie, the percussionist. And part 2, it speaks about Ustad Bismillah Khan, a great Shehnai player. And he is from India. I have already discussed with you, these two great musicians are from different corners of the country. She is from Scotland and he is from India. As I told you, these two great musicians is going to inspire us. I have completed part 1 for you, which revolves around the character of a great musician, Evelyn Glennie. Have you read part 1, children? Even in the moderator session on Saturday, I spoke to you regarding something. I asked you for the lines which it touched you from the lesson. Now, let us start the session. Last session, I just ended up with a quote. What is that quote? That is a quote of Evelyn Glennie where she told like, I am not a deaf musician, I was born deaf. What is the quote that is told by Evelyn Glennie? I am not a deaf musician, I am born deaf. She is a shining inspiration for deaf children. This line you could find in your textbook. She is a shining inspiration for deaf children. The last point of the lesson. So, she stands there as a shining inspiration for deaf children. Because she got this deafness at the age of 8 and she was sent to a deaf school. But she proved herself. She achieved something in her life. That is something great. And you could see one more point over there. You could see that she has given inspiration to those who are handicapped. She has given enormous pleasure to millions of people. How you could justify this line, children? She has given enormous pleasure to millions of people because the path which she have selected is music. And as I have told you, she is the lady who could play 1,000 instruments with perfection. That is why she has given enormous pleasure. The meaning of the word enormous, major amount of pleasure to million people. And this short story, it is written by Deborah Kovlay. You could see like this story gives inspiration to the one who are being disabled. As we have discussed, disabled people are not disabled. They are differently abled. Have you read part 1, children? Hope so you would have read part 1. Let us move into part 2 now. Yes, we are going to read part 2 now. Part 2, it describes about Ustad Bismillah Khan. He is an Indian and he is a Bharat Ratna recipient. He holds the prestigious award called Bharat Ratna. If you have started reading part 2, some people you would have started reading part 2, you could see this Bharat Ratna recipient. We are going to see about the person Ustad Bismillah Khan. Now, to move into the thing, the story begins like this. First, you could see an musical instrument called Pungai. What is the name of the musical instrument? Pungi. Okay, Pungai or Pungi, you can give the pronunciation. And you can see one more musical instrument also over there. It is Shehnai. Have you come across this musical instrument Pungai, children? Anywhere? Just think over it. Have you come across this musical instrument? Yes, few of my students are answering good. Ma'am, we have seen this musical instrument with snake charmers, ma'am. Snake charmers to tame their snakes, to make their snakes behave accordingly. So, the instrument which came into existence first is this Pungai. But later, some people felt that the music produced by this instrument is not good. This Shehnai and the other thing which we are having now like guitar, flute, everything was taken the source from this Pungai. Okay. So this is what you have to be very clear. The first musical instrument to come into performance was this Pungai, but now Shehnai is being used. Ustad Bismillah Khan is a good, great musician who could play the Shehnai in a very great manner, and he has received Bharat Ratna. So this Shehnai has not originated by itself. It had its source from the other reeded instrument called Pungai. Okay, be clear with this, children. The story begins like this. You could see that in the textbook. Pungai become the generic name for reeded noisemakers. So this has become the reeded noisemakers, reeded instrument for the noisemakers. When this is played at the court, will the king be pleased of this instrument, children? He won't feel pleased over there. That is the reason why. So this musical instrument was not allowed to be played at the court, at the king's court. You could read this point in first para. This Pungai is not allowed to be used in king's court. What is the reason? Because this is something described as noise makers. Do we say music as noise makers? We don't say like this. And are you familiar with this instrument, children? So we call this in Tamil as Magudi. Magudi, which is used by the snake charmer. That is the reason why you could see in point 1, when this special instrument is played at king's court, it was something unpleasant. It was considered to be noise maker. It was not pleasant to ears. That is the reason why the king told that such musical instrument is not supposed to be played. And it was not given place in the king's court. That is the reason why you could see Shehnai came into existence. Shehnai is a musical instrument with holes in it. It came into existence. And this sound of Shehnai is something auspicious. What is the meaning of the word auspicious, children? Adorable, respected. And nowadays, this musical instrument, Shehnai, has an indispensable component of any wedding. What is the meaning of the word indispensable? Which could not be taken. Indispensable, something which is important, unavoidable. The meaning of the word indispensable is unavoidable. So this shenoy could not be taken from the component of today's wedding. Are you clear with the thing now? When this shenoy is compared with this pungai, no, it has nothing pleasant over there. So, when you read point 2, you could see there will be a person who just invent this shenoy and he plays that in Shah's court. And he is also a barber over there. Since it is played in Shah's court and the person who played this instrument is called as a barber. There is a term which is used for nai, that is barber. That is the reason why it is being termed as shenoy. You have to read point 2, children, to get a clear understanding. And from point 3, you can see that once when this shenoy was invented, you could see like it could not be taken from North Indian wedding specially. It had its essence in North Indian wedding. It has become the indispensable component of any wedding. It could not be removed. It could not be taken away. Have you seen the traditional wedding? Typical Hindu traditional wedding hall? It will have the element of this. That is what is being portrayed in the lesson. Auspicious. I have given you the meaning of the word auspicious. Something which is adorable. Praiseworthy. Which has its own respect. You have to read point 2 to get the idea of this. I am not reading the text for you, children. You have to read the point and I am just highlighting the ideas. This is what will be given over there. Now we have completed around 3 paras of part 2. If you are going to read it, you could see points like this. Will you read it? You have to read it. Next, when we move on to the next point, the credit for bringing this instrument onto a classical stage goes to Usmat Bismillah Khan. So, I have already told you, this instrument, shenoy, was introduced by a barber. This instrument, shenoy, was introduced by a barber and the tradition of bringing this to the classical age, the credit goes to Ustad Bismillah Khan. That is what we are going to see in the lesson now, in part 2. And you could see here the age, the date of birth of Ustad Bismillah Khan, 1916 to 2006. So he lived from 1916 to 2006. Even though instrument would have been invented, but the people who brings it to improvisation, who improves the quality of it, the credit goes to some people. And that credit here goes to Ustad Bismillah Khan. Are you clear with the thing? Start reading part 2, children. You could get inspiration from Ustad Bismillah Khan over here. We have completed around 4 points. Start reading part 2. Have your textbook in hand to follow the lesson. Ma'am is just highlighting you some of the ideas. You just get the interest of reading the whole point what is given over there. That will help you a lot. And if you are simply going to listen to the classes, you cannot get anything. Have your textbook in hand. Read the thing. I will just highlight you the ideas. Textbook reading and seeing this presentation should go hand in hand. Only then you will get a clear picturization of what is going on. Have your textbook, listen to the slides which is prepared by me, listen to my explanation, keep on reading. That will give you a clear understanding of what is going on. It should go hand in hand. Only then you will get a clear picture of what is given. Will you do it? I want my children to do it.